Hey guys, these vids aren't for monetary gain. I'm sure you're bored with Netflix, and I'm just trying to help. There's no monetary gain with these. There's no Patreon. I just figured you guys wanted something else to watch, something new, something different. So, here we go. The little tiny lunchbox. If any of you guys have watched my videos, you would see this little truck that was up there about 10 years ago. It's just a stock lunchbox that I painted black to be different. Didn't really put the decals in the right spot, but alcohol may have been a factor. Anyhow, man, I just went to pick this truck up off the shelf. And look what I did. I put my big fat meat hook in here like I always do to pick up this truck, and it went boing. Look at that. I broke it. I can't say I don't ever play with this truck, because I do, and I have a lot of fun with it. But I was really bummed out when I broke that. That's broken too. But that's broken because I was pissed off at the old lady and I kicked the damn truck. No, it was not the lunchbox's fault. But it's either kick the truck or kick the old lady. I'm sure you guys both know exactly what I'm talking about. So, anyway, this little lunchbox is essentially stock. I do have some associated RC10 rear shocks mounted up front, which doesn't change anything as far as with the way the thing handles. I mean, it still handles like a lunchbox, but rear springs, hell yes. Front springs, actually kind of disappointing. And I only say this because I'm actually kind of bummed that I did that. So maybe someday I'll actually put the stock shocks back on it and go out and have fun with the thing. But the truck is essentially stock. Oh, if I can get the very aggravated body off. There we go. Lunchbox. That is the factory speed control that came with it, which I forgot that I even put in there. I thought there was something else. I have a monster Futaba receiver again, which I forgot I even put in there. And as far as the steering servo, actually, I don't know. Let's find out. What is it? shit, I don't know. What is it? Looks like an S4. Sorry, guys. Oh, there it is. Can you guys read it? Let me see if I can get you some light. There's light in there, but you can't read it. Too covered with swill. Give me just a second. Take a scratch off. You don't know for sure what you got until you scratch it off. What do we got there? 9401. I have no idea what that is. I think that's a high torque servo, if I remember correctly. Man, it's been such a long time. But, yep, there's the lunchbox. It hasn't gone anywhere, it's still here. Got some broken parts I have to replace, but I'm actually kind of thinking about picking up a Hornet just to kind of put next to it. I mean, why wouldn't you? Lunchbox, Hornet, Grasshopper, Frog. Why not, right? Oh, yeah, I forgot to talk about the motor I put in this thing. I put a motor in this a long time ago, actually, when I built it. I don't know what the turns are on it, but it's an ESP. ESP. I don't know. It stands for Elite Speed Products, apparently, with what the sticker says on it. But it's been so long since I built it, I don't remember what the motor was. I mean, obviously an ESP, but if you notice, it's got a flat spot on the motor can. Looks like the old Trinity Midnight. Don't know. I don't know for sure what it is, but it's not really any faster than the stock. But weren't these fast enough from the factory? I mean, your front tires are all round within, oh, I don't know, two battery packs, and the back tires are almost bald from spinning out from reverse, because obviously you can't spin out going forward, but... And the little tiny wheelie bar is getting super puny. Little wheelie bar wheel is getting puny. All them sweet fucking wheelies. And in case you were wondering, that is not a hairdryer in the background. I am actually charging the battery in the Baja. So, it's odd that it kicked the battery, kicked the fan on. Well, there we go. See, I didn't do it. It did it. Sorry. Anyway. I love that charger. There's actually a... It's not a review, but there's a video about it. Love it. So, anyway, guys. There's the lunchbox. And the Claude Buster. An S10 fender that's brand new. An S10 hood that's brand new. More RC cars. If you paid attention, I just put a video up on that. There's a Savage up there. That's Russell. I have one video of Russell on the internet. That is my 90-something mile an hour Traxxas Rustler. It is ridiculously fast. I mean, like 75 miles an hour, go from quarter throttle to half throttle, flips over backwards. Way too fast. Let's see. Motors Castle 5700 running on a 3-cell, I do believe it's got a 57 tooth pinion. I might be wrong on the pinion gear, but a huge pinion gear. Super tiny ring gear. But anyway, there's the lunchbox. I need to put up another video of this. Something tells me somebody wants to watch this. Well, again, like I said, guys, this shit is not monetized. My videos have never been monetized. I mean, I've got some carb tuning videos that have over 100,000 views, and I've never charged a penny for it. So, I started doing YouTube for fun, because that's what I wanted to do. I don't want to charge you guys to watch me play with my cars. And I don't want to charge you guys to watch me work on my cars. So, I mean, I'm not asking for thumbs. I'm not asking for subscriptions. I'm not looking for any of that shit. I don't really care. I just put it up because I want to. And right now, we're kind of going through some shit. And I thought, you know, maybe it'd be cool to show you guys some old RC cars that I've had around for a long time. You know, maybe it's an homage to say thank you for the 700 plus subscribers I have. You know, I wasn't really thinking about that, but hey, thanks guys. You know, well, I hope you enjoy the videos. I'm going to try to put up a couple more as soon as I can. So I guess I'll see you when I see you. Bye, guys.